In order to find the force in each cable needed to support the 500-pound crate, we can start by drawing our free body diagram for joint A by placing the origin at that particular point. Here, three cables are connected to point A, starting with the crate that has a weight of 500 pounds. Next, we have a cable from A to C making an angle of 20 degrees from the horizontal x-axis, whereas the cable A to C makes an angle of 35 degrees with respect to the negative x-axis. Once we have all the forces listed, let's go ahead and apply the equilibrium condition by adding all the forces along the x-axis. Here, only two components of the force FAC and FAB act along the positive and the negative direction. So we can figure out a relationship of FAB in terms of FAC. Next, we can go ahead and do the summation forces along the z-axis. Here, the weight of the crate is acting vertically downward. That's why it is taken as negative, whereas the component of force FAC and FAB will be pointed in the upward direction. We can calculate those components by taking the sine function of 20 degrees and sine function of 35 degrees. Simplifying, we get the value of FAC as 574 pounds. Next, we can go ahead and place that information in equation 1 and solve for FAB, that is coming as 500 pounds. Once we have those values, now we can go ahead and draw our free body diagram for joint C. We have already calculated the force from C to A, that is 574 pounds, that is making an angle of 35 degrees with respect to the horizontal x-axis. The other two cables that are acting downward from C to E and C to F, their length can be calculated using our Pythagorean theorem, which is coming as 25 feet. Similarly, we can calculate the length from C to D using the Pythagorean theorem as well, that is coming as 26 feet. Once we have all the dimension, we can go ahead and start applying our equilibrium condition, starting with summation of forces along the x-axis. So our 574 pound force, the cost function of that will give us the component along the positive x-axis, whereas the FCD, if we multiply that with 10 over 26, will give us the component along the negative x direction. Simplifying, we get the value of FCD. Next, we can go ahead and apply the equilibrium condition along the y direction. Here, only two components of the force FCE and FCF are acting along the positive and negative y direction. That makes those two forces equals to one another. Finally, we can apply the summation of forces along the z-axis. So for them, the two components of FCE and FCF is going vertically downward by multiplying them with 24 over 25, whereas the 574 pound force, if we take the sine 35 function, it's also going in downward direction, whereas the z component of FCD will be positive as it is pointed in the upward direction, which can be calculated by multiplying it with 24 over 26. Simplifying, we can calculate the value of FCF, that is coming as 416 pounds. Since that is equals to FCE, that value is also 416 pounds.